first line of the program is hash include stdio.h standard input output header file. Why? Because I am including, that means I am using printf and scanf functions in my program. Next, declare the stack globally s of 20. What is the data type of stack? Is it integer or character? If it is the opening symbol, then push into the stack. Symbols are nothing but characters in a C language. So char s of 20. Initially declare TOS pointer or variable. Declare TOS variable whose value is 1 initially. TOS is a variable that always points to the topmost element. Initially stack is empty, that's why TOS points to the -1. Next, here I am using stack data structure, that's why we have to write the definitions for push function as well as pop function. Void push of char x, where x is the opening symbol, whether it may be parenthesis, bracket or base. S of plus plus toss is equal to x. Next, coming to the pop. Pop means deleting an element. Char pop return s of toss minus minus. So these are the shortcuts for push as well as pop functions. Here I am declaring the stack globally and stack variable, that is top of the stack variable, initially it is -1. Stack means main important operations are push as well as pop. Okay. Next, before writing the main function, I have to write the function whether the symbols are matched or not. How to write the logic whether the symbols are matched or not? Every left parenthesis should have the matching right parenthesis. Every left bracket should have the corresponding matching closing bracket, that means a right bracket. Every left brace should have the corresponding right brace. So how to check for this one? By using this function. Assume that the function name is match. Return type of the function is integer, that means which returns integer value to the main function, which takes two character variables. Assume that char a comma char b. Assume that char a comma char b. Why I am taking two parameters? One is for the left symbol, another one is for the right symbol. For that particular purpose, I am taking two character variables, char a as well as char b. First one is if a double equals to left parenthesis. If a is left parenthesis, then it should have the corresponding right parenthesis, and b is equal to closing parenthesis, right parenthesis, then return 1, then return 1. That's why, the what is the return type of this match function? Integer. Next, else if a is equal to opening bracket and corresponding one is b is equal to closing bracket, then return 1. Else if a is equal to opening parenthesis and logical and b is equal to closing brace, a equal to opening brace, logical and b is equal to closing brace, then also return 1. Else finally return 0. Finally return 0. So this is the logic to check whether the symbols are balanced or not. It checks for two symbols. If your first parameter is opening symbol, then it should have the corresponding right parenthesis, then only return the value 1. What is this operator? Logical AND operator. Coming to the logical AND operator, the second operand is evaluated only when the first operand is true. Okay, that means if both are true, 1 and 1, then only it returns 1. Here also when both are true, that means these two are matched, then it returns 1. When these two are matched, it returns 1. If none of the conditions are matched, then it returns 0. Next, I am going to write the main function. After the push function, pop function, as well as match function definitions, next, write the main function definition into main of void. into main of y. Technical way to write the main function. Next, declare a character array to hold the input expression. So cap e of some 20 comma one pointer, character pointer p comma two variables. Assume the t comma x or t y choice is yours. T comma x. Next, printf. We are asking the user enter the expression. Enter the expression. So scanf percentage s comma e p is equal to e. Up to now, this is common for all my programs. Okay, whether it is infix to postfix or evaluation of postfix or balancing of symbols, this is common. So scan the expression from left to right. That is the first one. Scan the given expression by star p which is not equals to backslash zero. Scan the given expression from left to right. What is the first one? Ignore operands and operators. Okay. Next, if it is the opening symbol, then push into the stack. If it is the opening symbol, that means if star p is equal to opening parenthesis or star p which is equal to closing parenthesis, opening bracket, or star p is equal to opening brace, then if it is the opening symbol, then push into the stack. Push off star p. Push off star p. Next, if it is the closing symbol, if star p is equal to opening closing parenthesis or star p is equal to closing bracket or star p is equal to closing brace. If it is the closing symbol, then what is the first step? Check whether the stack is empty or not. If stack is empty, that means if TOS is equal to minus 1, that indicates printf unbalanced. Symbols are not balanced, that means unbalanced. Then return. No need to check the remaining ones, so simply return. Next, if it is the closing symbol and stack is not empty, stack is not empty means coming to the else block, coming to the else block, then pop an element from the stack, that is t equals to pop, t equals to pop. Next, I am calling the match function, not match of, not match of, what it is, t comma star p. Here the important one is t comma star p, not star p comma t. Why? Because coming to my match function, I am checking opening symbol with closing, opening bracket with closing bracket, opening brace with closing brace. So what is the first parameter? Opening. Pop means stack contains only the opening symbols. Okay, that is my t. That's why the first parameter is t. First parameter is the opening symbol t, my stack element. Star p means is the input. If these two symbols are not matched, then printf. Not means not matched, then printf unbalanced. Then return. No need to check the remaining ones. Return. Closing of else block. Okay. Next, closing of if block. Next, coming to the while, to go to the next character p plus plus, p plus plus, closing of while. So this is the logic. When an expression ended, if the stack is not empty, then unbalanced. If the stack is empty, then balanced. So if toss is equal to minus 1, if stack is empty, then balanced. Printf balanced. Else, printf unbalanced. Why? Because when an expression ended and stack is not empty, then unbalanced. Return 0. Last line is return 0. Closing of main function. First example is a plus b. backslash 0. E as well as P, both are points to that particular index. While star P, what is star P? Opening parenthesis is not equals to the backslash 0. Yes, condition is true. So coming to the inside, E star P is the opening symbol. What is star P? Left parenthesis. Yes, star P is the opening symbol. Then push into the stack. Push into the stack. Next, P plus plus. P plus plus means go to the next one. A. A is not equal to backslash 0. Condition is true. Is A is equal to the opening symbol? No. Is A equals to the closing symbol? No. Coming to the next one is P plus plus. Plus is not equals to the opening symbol and plus is not equals to the closing symbol. This is the way to ignore operands and operators. Plus B also. Next one is backslash 0. So while star P means backslash 0 not equals to backslash 0, condition is false, coming out of the while block. When an expression ended, if stack is not empty, then unbalanced. If stack is empty, then balanced. What is the value of toss? First element, now TOS points to that element, so index is 0. 0 double equals to minus 1, condition is false. Coming to the else block, unbalanced. Symbols are not balanced. This is the first one. And the second example is this is our second example. Okay. What is the first one? Opening symbol not equal to backslash 0. Condition is true. If it is the opening symbol, then push into the stack. Push. Second one is also push. Ignore operands and operator. Next one is closing. If it is the closing symbol, is stack is empty? Stack is not empty. Then coming to the else block, T equal to pop. T equal to pop means which element is pop? The topmost element is pop. Next, if, important one is, I am calling the match function, match of. What is the first parameter I am passing? T. T means opening symbol. Star P means given input. Input is the closing symbol. We have to pass the first parameter as the T. Why? Because coming to the match function, what is my first parameter? Opening symbol checked with closing symbol. Opening symbol checked with closing symbol. So first parameter must be opening symbol. That's why T equals to pop. My stack contains always the opening symbols. That's why first pass the parameter T, next to pass the star P. This particular one, whether these two symbols are matched or not, if they are matched, okay, not matched. Not matched means unbalanced, but these two symbols are matched. So, out of the if, out of the if. Next, P plus plus goes to the next one. Is it is the opening symbol? No, it is the closing symbol. When it is the closing symbol, is stack is empty? No, stack is not empty. Then T equals to pop. So this element is popped. T equals to opening one. Next, if of not match of T comma star P, match of T means opening, star P means closing. Is these two are matched? No, not matched. Not matched means true, condition is true. So coming to the inside, unbalanced. These symbols are